When Toyota made the announcement that Land Cruiser was going to be shelved, a lot of people were devastated by it. And there was no indication that it was ever coming back. And so earlier this year, when Toyota made the announcement, hey, we're bringing the Land Cruiser back, that created a ton of excitement. So we decided to look in the vault, see what we had. We found the Retro Cruiser that was built by Millen Motorsports back in 1999 and said, what's it gonna take to get this thing back up to SEMA quality? The Retro Cruiser started out as a 67 FJ45. When Millen got his hands on it, he lengthened it about a foot. He made it about half a foot wider, and then they put a Toyota V8 in it. They built this vehicle to be able to be used in the dirt. All the rugged looks of the old 67 FJ style, but it has all the luxury of the 100 series, which was the top of the line Toyota comfort car in 2000. The grill had to have been extended somewhere here, and you can't see any kind of seams whatsoever, so they did a really good job on it. When it was originally built, this mirror sat on this side of the hinge, so the mirror did not move with the door. One of the things I love about this car, and I think that Rod did a fantastic job on it, is that the exterior still looks rugged. It looks like it belongs in the desert. But in the meantime, you're getting out of a pretty luxurious vehicle. This is the new carpet inside of it. It matches really good on the interior. It has a good contrast. All in all, not only is it a cool car, but it's also a well-built car. So we got done with the mechanical side of everything we thought needed to be done. So now we're looking at doing the part of the job that we don't do here internally. We talked to the experts over at Complete Customs. They're just down the road from us in McKinney. I'm gonna point out the things that I've noticed on it in the last couple days. You can't just shut it easily.
To be adjusted maybe, or?
We did some mechanical at our shop. When we picked this thing up, under each corner, was this big giant stain, kind of a bubble. It looked like bees had made honey. The shock oil was just coagulated down there like that. Oh, wow. We had to use scrapers to get it off the ground and everything. So at that point we knew, okay, the shocks probably need to be rebuilt. Yeah. And that's kind of what started our whole thing. Then we found out the fuel system was kind of jacked up and a lot of the hoses were rotted out. So we made it mechanically sound underneath.
Nice.
And
so you guys have done all that. You guys went through maintenance, everything.
It's maintenance.
It's good to go.
Yeah, awesome. It's good enough that we sent Paul, our group manager for motorsports, out to King of the Hammers to go drive around in it.
So we have the opportunity to go in and hard paint this whole complete vehicle. Basically strip it all down, go back, freshen it up a little bit. Gonna go back with the same colors.
Mainly, we're just gonna dial in the color match. We're gonna get the colors spot on. We're gonna clean the whole thing up and we're gonna refresh it. And we're gonna make it look as good as it did when it came back out in 1999.
That's what I hope, is that this inspires a whole nother generation of Land Cruiser lovers.